Veterans Affairs Accountability and Whistleblower Protection Act, which also shortens what can sometimes be the years-long appeals process, and employees can't be paid while they appeal disciplinary or firing decisions. This, again, all in the wake of the issues that happened in Phoenix and at other VA facilities across the country. It's been a few months. How's it working so far?
I think that this is a piece of legislation that was necessary. And I surfaced the case of a psychiatrist who was watching pornography in the presence of a veteran during his clinical care. And the fact that I wasn't able to move them out of their job really said to me, this has gone on too far. We need a change in the law. We need the ability to move people out when they have clearly deviated from professional standards and ethical standards. And so now we have a law that allows us to have due process for employees, because I believe strongly that our employees need due process and need to be in a just environment, but also allows us, when the facts do support it, to move them out. We have, during this year, moved about 1,000 VA employees. Either they've been fired, they've been demoted, or they've been suspended for these types of issues. We publish that again every week, the only agency that does that, so that we can be held accountable for our own actions. Here in Washington, D.C., I did have to remove a director of our facility, of our VA here, because of management issues. I removed them under the old accountability authorities. The judge brought them right back. Once the accountability law went in place, I fired him again, so twice. And now we have management in place that I have confidence in that's fixing the problems at the Washington, D.C. VA. So these are authorities that I think help us do our job better and begin to change the VA to be the type of organization that we all believe it should be.
Does every one of these issues cross your desk? All of the ones that have to be disciplined?
No.
So the only ones that would come to your level are like hospital managers?
Very rarely do these come to my level. I am trying to stop VA being run out of Washington, D.C. VA needs to be run out in the field where the care is, and we need to give those who are responsible for running facilities both the authority and the accountability to get their jobs done right. And so this should be less about control out of Washington. We get involved only when it's at the very highest levels or when we're concerned about some of the decisions being made in the field.
And so you've removed people from management, you removed that one guy for doing inappropriate things in front of a patient. What other kinds of things have led to people's termination since the law came into effect?
Well, certainly when people are found involved in diverting drugs, when there are patient safety issues, I think what we're trying to adhere to are the standards that the private sector uses, and just trying to bring modern management techniques into government and allowing us the authority to be able to make those decisions. We don't want the VA to be an environment where people are fearful about their jobs. The vast majority of our employees are dedicated, terrific professionals, and we want to support them in their roles. But if you work in the VA and you see somebody who's working alongside you, who's not working and not doing their job and not respecting veterans, you don't want them working alongside you. So our employees have been very supportive of the accountability actions that we're taking, but they want to see that we're doing it in a fair way, and I hope we are doing this in a fair way. Yep.